Welcome to a new test and teardown video. This time it's another homebrew project. It's a Nixie clock, all homemade. If I look at that case, it's definitely reuse from something else. It's actually quite funny, the shape of this box. And what the heck was this box ever made for? What was its use originally? I don't know. But somebody built a Nixie clock into this case. And look at the bottom here. It says Philips. So that's all I know about this case. Some Philips thing. But a very, very special shape. But if I look inside the front here, it looks like the PCB is actually a professional PCB of some sort. You see the silk screen here? So let's try and power it up first and see if it works. So here we go. Let's power it up. 10 watts. Ooh, yo, there's a lot of leak. Nice switch. Let's run. Oh, well, that is difficult. Look at that. So when I push the switches, okay, that is, I don't know if you can hear the click, but every time I push the button, I get a new random, and then it comes, the idea is I hold it in, and then I let it go. Oy, that is the most buggy kind of set the clock kind of interface. That definitely does not work. So the idea maybe is you're turned off. And then. Nope. No. Lock. That is really funny. But it looks actually quite nice. Let's try and turn off the light here. Beautiful Nixies. You are not going to believe it. This is a kid. See? Definitely with silk screen and all that kind of stuff. So yes. And this is what, black cardboard? Just put in here. And if you look at the ICs, this one is from 76, and that is the youngest IC as far as I can see, 1976. All the other ICs there are older, but 76 is the youngest. If you look a little bit here on the PCB, you'll actually be able to see they tried to camouflage the origin of this. Down here you can see the silk screen has been removed, and it actually reads in Danish digital ur gentofte, so that is digital watch or digital clock. And up here you see MIS50 is written up there, and here on that PCB you see the I50, so it was MI and then S50 here on that PCB as well. And then you see some other text down there that has been removed completely, so I can't see anymore. But definitely, this was a kit. I don't know any more than that. Josti kit. That is Josti Electronic. Before they were called Josti Kit. Wow, that is old. So this is a very first Josti Kit. Maybe. Wow, fascinating. But definitely this set kind of thing does not work at all. Funny about this case and the shape of that case. I got no idea where that is coming from. It's very untraditional. But that was a lot of fun to find this. I will try and see if I can Google and call some of my friends. Is it possible to find some information on this? I've been playing a little bit more with this super nice Nixie clock kit. It turns out this kit is in fact a kit from Josti Electronic, exactly as it say here. And the kit is called MI950. So what you see here, it's actually 950 right there. And I was actually able to find schematics and everything online in a PDF file that says all about the kit, the schematic, the PCB layouts. Everything is explained in this nice PDF file. So that was very interesting to find. It also turns out that Josti Electronic and Josti Kit is actually, they started as the same company and then they split up and became two different companies. So that is why this Josti name. Also, when I'm looking in here, I saw some goop. I don't know if you can see it down here, this sticky stuff. I've been trying to clean it up a little bit. And look at the wires here. Around this capacitor, you can actually see it's wet. Down here, let me get some light. So that reveals, see? Sticky, ooh, it's still sticky, right? So this reveals this capacitor actually puked. So we got some capacitor slappity-snack all the way around here. Maybe that is why they. I don't understand exactly why we got two of them in parallel. Those are the high voltage capacitors for the Nixie anode voltages. And you can also see this PCB was cut so that this kit could go into this really special case. And then this little slide of the power supply PCB was also cut. See, this is the transformer. And the transformer was supposed to be mounted here on this PCB and wires down here and all that. And then this little input part of it with the fuse was also cut out and mounted here. So quite a lot of modifications. And here is the 5-volt regulator. But look at that. Can you see the brown capacitor and the input wire here, and that capacitor is actually touching the output. There's zero safety distance there. So that is a problem waiting to happen. As you can imagine, if the input and the output is shorted, you'll get full voltage out on all your ICs, and it's probably gonna blow up the entire clock. And it is 0 point nothing safety distance around that. That is really amazing. So I'll of course have to fix that. So now I've been cleaning up all this slime around everywhere, but it actually turns out that I think it is now coming from the wires. Because all those wires, they were like sticky and slimy all over the place. But it's not coming from capacitors, really. They're nice and dry. But it's all the wires. And you can actually see it down here because I couldn't come in here and clean up the wires down here. So isn't that a little bit weird? Some sort of a plastic coating or some kind of composition inside the wires? that turns them into sticky slimy. You can actually still see it in here. Wild. So that is what I think. I was also able to fix the little potential problem around the regulator here. I moved everything a little bit. So now it is nice and safe. It's still not super pretty or anything, but at least we don't have a short circuit potential anymore. So while I was looking at the PDF from the internet, I also find price tag 575 Danish kroners in 1976. So that is 5 times more today due to inflation. So wow, that would have been a very, very expensive kit. I'm so sorry about this PDF file. It's of course all written in Danish, so I can't really tell you a lot more than just show you the nice pictures. Here on page 2, there's a really, really funny text. It says, "This digital watch has this advantage. It consists of all 24 hours of the day, where a normal clock only contains 12 hours. I love it. And there you have it, the schematic of the clock readout section. And then they say about the text explains, oh, this is TTL electronics and it is working about 5 to 6 volts and all that kind of stuff. It says the counters and flip-flops and stuff like that. And the funny thing is that the most significant digit, it's decoded using 3 transistors and some diodes, gates and all that, instead of just using another 7490 and then another 74141 Nixie driver. But of course, they try to save money and make this a much more simple circuit. And there's the component part list. And it's actually really, really nice, this clock kit from 1976. So thank you very much for watching, and please come back again tomorrow.